Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Today I will tell you about the most efficient coaster design in the game, which is this tiny corkscrew coaster. It is extremely small, it is super cheap, it has decent stats and it also has a few other nice qualities. Before we talk about that, I'll quickly show you how to build it. You select the corkscrew coaster, build two station tiles, build half a corkscrew, select powered launch mode, set it to the minimum launch speed of 35 km per hour, and you're done. The coaster itself is only 2x4 tiles large, for a total of 8 tiles, which includes the entrance and exit buildings. This is absolutely tiny. It is smaller than a 3x3 flat ride like the merry-go-round. It can be even smaller still, as if you build these coasters in a row, they can overlap a bit, making the effective size only 2x3 tiles. You cannot do this though if you use my favorite queue line layout for this coaster, which looks like this. Now it's 3x4 tiles and you can just plop down this saved design pretty much anywhere and have a functioning coaster. Not only is this design minuscule, it is also dirt cheap. In fact, not only is it smaller than a merry-go-round, it is also cheaper. A merry-go-round costs 460 euros, while this tiny corkscrew only costs 349 euros. It being a coaster, it does of course have higher operating costs than a merry-go-round, so after a year it will be more expensive, but that's very much worth it as it can make you a lot of money. Now, obviously, bigger coasters with much higher stats will make you more money, but for its size and price, the tiny corkscrew is almost unrivaled. Assuming you have more than one of these in your park, you can still charge more than 7 bucks for it if it's under 5 months old. With a maximum throughput of about 2,600 guests per hour, it can make you quite a bit of money. If you want, you can add a photo section at the back to make even more money. I don't really ever do this since it does take up more space and the guests can only buy one photo from this entire list of ride types. If you place 4 tiny corkscrew coasters like this, you have 4 decent money makers for the price of less than 1700 euros in the space of only 6x8 tiles. You can expand this to as many tiny corkscrews as you want. Including the path around and between the coasters, these 24 coasters take up 19x22 tiles and only cost you 11,664 euros. There is no other coaster design that can rival this efficiency. This design is also very useful in pay-for-entry scenarios. Every ride type attracts a certain number of guests to the park, and with 100 there are only 4 ride types that attract more guests than the corkscrew coaster does. The same setup from before attracts 2,400 guests to the park, while also providing the guests with 24 fun rides. You can easily spam this design everywhere if you need to quickly increase the soft guest cap to get more guests into your park. There is one question remaining though. How on earth does this coaster design not get severe penalties to its excitement rating from missing 2 of its stat requirements? Well, whenever the corkscrew coaster has at least one inversion, all stat requirements, except the one for the maximum speed, are ignored. This design manages to both just about get the speed requirement of 36 km per hour and just about get far enough up the corkscrew so that it counts as an inversion. You can actually build the same design with the LIM launch coaster, which even is a bit cheaper and has a bit higher stats. However, it only attracts 55 guests to the park, and its higher nausea rating causes more vomit, so I don't consider it to be better than the Corkscrew coaster. In OpenRCT2, you can also build the same design with the inverted coaster, as it now gets a launched mode, just like in Rollercoaster Tycoon 1. It also has a bit higher stats, so it can also make a bit more money. Once again though, I don't consider it better than the Corkscrew coaster, as it is a little bit more expensive and causes a bit more vomit, and the inverted coaster is available in scenarios much less often than the Corkscrew coaster. And that is everything you need to know about the Tiny Corkscrew coaster. If you ever have any trouble with a scenario and you have the Corkscrew coaster available, this design will very likely be able to help you out, no matter the problem. If you liked this video, consider giving it a like or leave a comment. You can also subscribe or follow me on Twitch. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video.